Welcome to TradingFloor.com's weekly Asia Focus. In this report with Andrew Robinson, correspondent for Saxo Capital Markets, we take snapshots of some recent main market events and news in Australia and China and do a quick review of the latest Japanese trade data. We also take a special look at the Indonesian economy, which appears to be in good shape and could well be in for a ratings upgrade soon. Welcome, Andrew.
Hello again.
So we've had the US Vice President Joe Biden in Beijing meeting with Chinese Vice President Xi Jinping this week. What topics have been on the agenda, and are there any moves on the yuan?
I think basically this visit is more intended to be building up relationships with the Chinese Vice Premier, Mr. Xi. He is expected to become the president in 2013, so it's more of a shake hands, get to know each other kind of meeting, with no real items on the agenda. Before Biden left the US, the Treasury was still beating the drum about pressing China for further developments on the yuan revaluation. But so far, we've not seen anything since he arrived in China. The last two Chinese fixings have both been higher, the dollar-China fix. So there doesn't seem to be any hurry to appreciate the Chinese yuan. Having said that, I think that generally, the feeling is that the time might be right. There was an article in the China Securities Journal just before Mr. Biden arrived saying that the time was ripe for maybe expanding the trading bans that the yuan is restricted to on a daily basis. At the moment, against the US dollar, there's a 0.5% trading band. Against the likes of sterling, yen and Hong Kong dollars, the band is 3%. And against the likes of the ringgit and the ruble, the band is actually about 5%. So there is room for expansion of the trading band. And I just wonder whether we might see more developments on that sphere later in the month.
Looking to Japan now, how have the latest trade numbers panned out?
Well, we had the second trade surplus in 2 months, perhaps indicating that Japan is recovering from in the aftermath of the March disaster. Interesting to note that exports were lower to both the US and China, which is symbolic of the global slowdown that we're seeing in both of those economies. Imports were actually more or less as expected, perhaps slightly firmer, but I think that's more due to the higher commodities prices rather than increased activity. So generally a slightly positive report, but I think there is a risk that in the coming months we will see further slowing of the export data, certainly.
So they've survived the tsunami, things are sort of back to normal, but no full speed ahead from here.
I think yes, more of a slowing atmosphere in the general economy. Certainly more from the external situation rather than the internal situation. They have managed to get most of the supply chains back on the stream, so everything is ready. But it's unfortunately coming at a time when the rest of the global economy seems to be entering a bit of a soft patch.
And in Australia, we saw minutes released from the latest Reserve Bank of Australia meeting at the beginning of the month. Has there been much market reaction to the decision to leave rates unchanged? And what about the overall stance on the state of the economy from the bank?
I think, yes, generally before the meeting on the 2nd of August, the interest rate markets were looking at something like 16 basis points worth of easing within the next 12 months. Since we've had the meeting, that has expanded to something like 140 basis points. So certainly the RBA's view of the economy is that it is a bit fragile. The market is looking for, as I say, interest rate cuts within a year. We're a bit evenly balanced as to when the first cut might come. Westpac caused a bit of a stir a few months ago when they said they were expecting a rate cut before the end of the year. NAB came out today and said that they expect everything to remain flat or stable until the end of the year. So there is certainly the view that the next move will be a cut rather than a hike. And it's just a question of the timing. My favourite scenario would be that the RBA will wait and see, analyse the next few months of data and see how the external situation pans out before they make a next decision on the actual rate move.
And how about Indonesia? It has just unveiled its 2012 budget, which indicates growth in the economy of around 6.7% and an inflation rate of 5.3% next year. How has the Indonesian economy been performing, and is a ratings upgrade on the cards?
It seems to be performing very well. They came out of the 2008 global financial crisis relatively unscathed. 2009 growth dipped to 4.6%, and that was the lowest we'd seen for a few years. The only previous low one was in 2002 when it was below 4.5%. But in 2010 we had growth of 6.1%. And as you say, in 2012 they're looking at 6.7%. So generally it looks to be in fine form. One of the major problems with Indonesia in the past has been this issue with corruption, graft or cronyism. And Susilo Bambang Yudhoyono has been very adamant in his efforts to stamp out this kind of thing in the economy. So far, he's had a little bit of success, but I think there's still a long way to go. And this is perhaps being reflected in the Jakarta Stock Exchange. It's one of the best performing exchanges in the region for this year. At the moment, we are up something like 7.8%. Only matched slightly by the likes of Thailand, which is up 6% year to date. And if you remember what problems Thailand has been through with elections, etc., over the past few months, then Indonesia is still performing quite well. When you compare it to the likes of India, India is down 19% year on year, and the relatively stable Singapore exchange is down 11%. So the stock exchange is performing very well, and I think this is a reflection of what everyone's anticipating for the economy. When it comes to ratings upgrades, the last upgrade was in January by Moody's and in April by S&P. At the moment, Moody's has a stable outlook, S&P has a positive outlook. So under that environment, I think that when the next reviews come, shall we say January to April next year, then I think there's a very heavy chance that we will see a ratings upgrade. And that is something unusual to see in this current global environment of ratings downgrades and debt concerns. So at least we've got something positive to look at in the Asia region.
For sure. So an interesting economy to watch in Asia.
Yes.
Thank you for this insightful report, Andrew. And don't forget to read more of what Andrew's writing about on TradingFloor.com.